desert road. So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, of court official of the Candace. That is the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. She had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth, and his humiliation was, and justice was denied him. Who will tell of his prosperity, for his life is taken from the earth? Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth and began with the scripture passage. He proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is it to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop. And Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. And when they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.